वन स्पेन टू गिव द बायोडेटा ऑफ सुंदरराजन. He belongs to the Indian Administrative Service, IAS, of 1958 batch, Orissa cadre. He has served in Government of India as Under Secretary and Deputy Secretary in the Ministry of Petroleum and Chemicals and Joint Secretary State Plans in the Planning Commission. He has been composing stanzas in Sanskrit since he was 12-year-old. And I am fortunate to have gone through all those stanzas which have been published from his pen, published from Devavani Parishad, number 6, Vani Vihar, Delhi, 11-00-39, from the last 2 years. And he told me in the morning that the second volume is bigger than that and it's going to come in near future. May it come so that I can have a look at that also. He has been composing verses and has been blessed with the title Bala Kavi from His Holiness Chandrasekharendra Saraswati Mahaswamigal of Kanchi Kamakoti Peetham. He was conferred the honor of Samskrita Mitram by Ministry of HRD, Government of India 2002. He has been honored by Orissa Sanskrit Academy with Valmiki Samman. So, you know what Valmiki means? He is an Adi Kavi. Like that, in 20th century Sanskrit poetics, Sundararajan is the Adi Kavi. He has brought out novelty into Sanskrit poetry. He is not conforming only to traditional glory. Puranamityeva nasadu sarvam nachavikavyam navamityavadyam santaha pariksha anyatarat parante mudaha paraprathyane buddhi. As Kalidasa points out in Malavika Agnimitra, first act, third stanza. He has got the Lifetime Contribution Award to Indian Literature. Please give him a big hand. Lifetime Contribution. It's not a small honor. He has been blessed with Bharat Bharati Award 2008 for this. He has received Presidential Award for his proficiency and service to the cause of Sanskrit language and literature in 2005. He has been conferred the honorary degrees of Vidya Vachaspati D.Litt from Rashtriya Sanskrit Vidyapeetha Tirupati in 2008. He is a director of the board of local branch of Bharati Vidya Bhavan. That is what matters to us. He is a local branch of Bharati Vidya Bhavan. He is a Bhavanite of Orissa. We had Bhavanites of Trichy. We had Bhavanites of Tirupati. We had Bhavanites of Bombay. We also have Bhavanites from Orissa. So it is a Bhavan family which has come and joined ISKCON family. It is a family get together, which has happened for the second year, and after that is the third year, and which is going to happen for 2 more years. So, if government has got a 5-year plan, we also have got 5-year plan to execute in this context. He is the director of board of local branch of Bharati Vidya Bhavan Bhuvaneshwar and continuing and contributing as such for the last 15 years. That's the contribution. With these few words, may I now request Shri Sundararajan to take over and give his paper to us. Over to Shri Sundararajan.
Dr. Ranganathananda has praised me a lot, but I don't know how much I deserve. But I can tell people here that his name is Anvartha. Ranganatha means stage manager. Who manages the stage is Ranganatha. He is Anvartha. Secondly, the great day for me, some people go on holiday. I have a holy day. It is a holy day conference for me. On a holiday conference. Holy day, definitely a holy day, the holy conference, the holiest day, because today happens to be the birthday of Bhakti Sara. That is the, you know Bhakti Sara? Bhakti Sara is one of the 12 Alvars. Tirumaitri Alvar. Many people don't know. This is birthday of Tirumal Alvar. Tirumal Alvar is about the Ansha of Chakra Ayuda, Chakra Talwar. Chakra Talwar is one of the people who are born and reborn in cycle. We don't know. Bhagavadine, Viridani, Janmani, Tavacharjuna, Tanyaham, Medhi Sarvani, Matvam, Vedta, Parantara. We don't know who you are, how you have come. But Chakra Talwar is totally devoted to God, is bearing him. And for every act of God, Samhara, Siddhi, everything, he is responsible. And at that time, Sangapani, Chakrapani, Sangapani, two deities are there, Kumbhakonam. Chakra Talwar is doing so much of duty, you be born as Chakrayuda. And I will serve you. You see, when Bhaktisara was born, is born, you know the origin, and actually he was born in Tirumaishai, traveled to Kumbhakonam, where his samadhi is still there. I have seen the samadhi. The samadhi, Chakrayuda, is totally becomes, goes and sees Sargavani temple, and look at this thing. Why are you lying down there? I would like to talk to you. Please get up. He gets up. Uttana Sargavani. That's the place Sargavani is getting up. The deity gets up in his form, statue form, gets up. Uttana Sargavani, Uttana Sani. Uttana Sargavani gets up. There's a great distinct. You people go and see that. Samadhi is there. Chakrayuga is called, Tirumaishi Piran. Tirumaishi Piran becomes a master. And Sangamani, Aramda, becomes Alvar. Because Alvar is a stage boy and his master. And that is great. That great of Chakrayuga become either this thing. Piran, Shivali Piran, and Tangamanigam, Aramda Arvan. You must go to see the place. That's it. This is a holy day. That's the birthday of Tirumal Alvar. Sorry, I don't know. I will slip a paper from Mr. Ranganathan. I would like to. My paper is in his dream. I would like to abridge that. I think I must give the namaskar to assembly. I must start soon. Om Namasadase. नमस्सदस्पतये नमस्सकीनां पुरोगाणां चक्षुषे नमो दिवे नमः पृथिव्यै गुरुभ्यस्तद्गुरुभ्यश्च नमो वागमधीमहे प्रणीमहे च तत्प्राद्यौ दम्पती जगदम्पती दिशन्तु मे देव सदत्वदीयाः दया तरंगामुदा कटाक्षाः श्रोत्रे रुगुम्बाम् अमृतं क्षदन्तीं सरस्वतीं संशितकामधेनुं अक्षय शान्तिमकरं दरसप्रसक्तानि अभ्यर्थये मुरविदङ्गि सरोजभृङ्गानि कामं प्रसीदत यथाहमनम्यभावः कर्मामृतानि भवताम् अवतारयेयम्. The topic is message to mankind from Puranas with particular reference to Vishnu Purana. Narayanam namaskritya naram chaiva narottamam devim saraswatim vyasam tato jaya mudire. This is the first shloka recited by every devotee who embarks on reading the path Mahabharata. Essentially, this is a clarion call to the reader to say, Jai Bharat. We do say Jai Hind on every solemn occasion, which also means same thing. Mahabharat is also known as Jaya. As it describes, the victory of virtue, that is Dharma, over vice, that is Adharma, through steadfast devotion to God, to and doing one's duty. The following shloka of the Bhagavad Gita, in the following, Sandhya says, Yatra Yogeshwara Krishnaha, Yatra Partho Dhanudraha, Tatra Shrihi Vijayo Bhudihi, Dhruva Nitin Matil Mama. Mahabharata is an itihasa, that is ancient history. The other itihasa is Ramayana, which describes the life and deeds of Rama, the king of Ayodhya. Some scholars have considered Mahabharata as and Ramayana as Puranas. But the purpose of itihasas and Puranas is the only same thing, is only to understand Vedas. Itihas, this is a saying, itihasa puranabhyam, Vedam samupa brahmayat, brahmayate. And I expand the Vedas, understand the Vedas properly. The actual purpose of all the Shastras, like Vyakarana, grammar, Nirupta, etymology, Chandas, prosody, Kalpa, procedures, Jyotish, astrology, Shiksha, total incantation, the Upashastras, like Tarka, Logic, Mimamsa, Exegesis, and the 16 Kalas, Arts, are also fully understand the Vedas. Vedas are four, as all of you know, Rig Veda, Yajur Veda, Sama Veda, and Atharva Veda. This is from the exhaled breath of Lord Himself. Yasya Nishyojana Veda, that is the Vedic hymn. I think in Veda itself, there is no particular thing says whom the oblation to offer. This, Vedas don't make it clear. But the purpose, the creator, the God Himself, who issues the creation, that He doesn't want to conceal the purpose. He wants to you people to understand what is the purpose of creation, how He is created, how He is the whole universe is functioning. In that case, I think many supernatural powers visible to naked human eye, like fire, water, wind, earth, moon, sun, firmament, etc., have been created as gods. They are considered gods, each is God. But He is considered, He is now democratic, totally democratic. You think of gods, you go on offering them, but He is considered purpose. But He has laid down rules in the Vedas. Each one must follow the rules in the Vedas. Each creation also, Disha Smat, Vata Pavate, Disha Ureti Sujaha, everybody is trembling. And you know the Creator, everybody knows the Creator, but you offer the oblation to Him. But that's what the Veda says, the oblation offered. But who I am, He will not know from the Veda. That is why the whole thing is concealed. That concealed situation comes later, Upramana, that is Itihasa Purana, and the Upanishad. That's what I am telling you. Vedas is actually a Dharma Shastra par excellence. King Bhoja describes the greatness of Vedas as Dharma Shastra in the following shloka of his Sampuramana, of his our great testament, Dr. Ranganath. Uchai Gadihi Jagati Siddhyati Dharma Dashyati Tasya Pramaja Vatanehi Kritake Tarishyati तेषां प्रकाशादशाचमही सुरश्चेत् तानन्तरेण निपतेति कोनुमत्प्रमामः विश्वक all creations by God, the mortal, immortal, they have got different period of life. Creatures, whether mortal or immortal, have a different period of life. Immortals have, however, astral bodies. We have only gross bodies. They are astral bodies. That we don't know. But some of them say they are one, only mantra, their bodies are mantras. Their bodies only consist of mantras. There's not no physical body like that. That question, Mimamsaka is questioning like that. But at a great conference was held in Amesha, about these people have got bodies, they have been this Devadas, have bodies, dog bodies like this or not. And the whole thing was settled, there after discussion. It says, Indra also has a physical form, color, and weapons. His whole thing settled. Naima Shanda asked by the conference of the rishis, settled. Similarly, most of the other devatas have also the mantra of God for physical form, color, and weapons. This discussion is not germane to our present context. We are seeking to find out what is the identity of Bharadevata through the Puranas. Puranas has the identity of Bharadevatas. That's very important. People talk about Bhagavad Purana, exactly Hari. Hari is the total distinct Bhagavad Purana. And actually it is Krishna. Vedas describe about the creation of Devas and Asuras through Pradapati. The hymn is that, Pradapati Deva Asmaha, you know that. Vishnu Devanam Pratamaha Sambhavuva Agni Avamaha. This is a sequence of the Devas. The sequence, in the pantheon of the Vedas, it is said there are 33 crores Devadas. In 13 groups. Rudra 11, Aditya 12, Vasu 8, and Ashwin Kumar 2. This is the 33 group and 33,000 crore devatas this is. Upati Mukodi devatas. Puranas seek to establish the identity of Paramatma through the analysis, starting from origin of creation, from void, running through the creation with Mahat, Ahanka, Manas, Jnanendra, Kamendriya, three qualities, Sattva, Rajas and Tamas. These describe destruction and reconstruction and cycle of such paths followed during the long years of time. Cycle is called Kala Chakra. Kala Chakra headed by the Brahma himself, no doubt. But the Brahma has no time. Brahma is only 100 years old. Even years of life. We have maybe calculated that. One day of Brahma's life is equal to one kalpa. That is 8 billion years. 8 billion human years is one day of Brahma's life. It will be 100 years. One day, 365 days, and 100 years. That is Brahma's life. Who is Brahma for that? Who is Brahmanda created by him? And the whole country is. Brahmanda is in the world of Krishna. Krishna is a total distinct as all the Brahmandas. That sort of thing is difficult to comprehend. Essentially, this is mind boggling for a small mortal like to comprehend this. That is why this Krishna said, Bahuni me vidhidhani janmani tavajadina chanyaham veta dravani tattvam veta parandana. This evidently shows the infinite compassion and mercy of God who takes incarnation in different forms, including human forms. And Lord Krishna spoke these words in his 9th avatar. As 9th avatar. Puranas tell us about genealogy of the kings in chronology, sequence of the rulers, they ruled Yuga, Yuga, Arthur, they don't narrate the history. Only main activities are captured. The other activity, you can call chronicle. Everything is chronicle, it will be run into pages, thousands of millions of pages. You see, that is said, Valmiki Ramayana, Valmiki wrote a total day-to-day of the chronicle. That is contributing 3 lakh pages. Supposing you write Ramayana 3 lakh pages, nobody will read it. So this condensed, Valmiki Ramayana condensed 24,000 stories. That only original chronicle is kept in Brahma Loka. Partly it's available. It is gathered here. It is out from Brahma Loka. So that is why the Purana condenses all various chronicles. The otherwise you mean in the endless this thing. You are mentioning here. The sage Valmiki, this thing. He said that the day-to-day record of activities of Lord Rama have been chronicled and preserved in the archives of Brahmaloka. Sage Valmiki, I mean contemporary chronicler, has narrated mainly police, I mean certain events, main events, historic events. But that the original existing chronicle is in the Brahmaloka. But you see, this chronicle cannot be dismissed as only Maitala. Purana is not Maitala. Purana may be Puranava. It is definitely the old history. But history only checkered, only anecdotes and episodes are preserved. And some serious concept, sequence are given there. But sequences, you can't say that this is totally, I mean, without proof. It's not scientific. Purana, mythology, see, Purana has been dismissed as mythology as it lacks archaeological or architectural proof. In my view, this is erroneous. In my view, actually, see, supposing we have got old past occurrences, CCTV, one phenomenon. Past occurrence, you captured in CCTV. Then the whole thing replay. How it occurred? CCTV has captured past occurrences. Whatever it be. The CCTV is a phenomenon. So automatically says past occurrences can be chronic. So whatever you have done, you are thinking that you are testing the past occurrence. Can be recorded, has been recorded. But human memory is difficult for us to understand that. So, yeah. Anyway, I come to the main Purana set now. There is no clarity about the number of Puranas, Mahapuranas. We have got 18 Puranas, we know many people understand. But actually, some people say 23, some say 25, 20 Puranas also mentioned somewhere. But 18 Mahapuranas are accepted, and only in that Vishnu Purana is one of the major Puranas. Krishna Dvaipayana is the author. Krishna Dvaipayana is the author of the this Purana. Krishna Dvaipayana Vidhi Vyasam Vidhi Narayana Prabhu Ko Hyanyo Gubi Maitreya Mahabharata. This is Parashara's own words. Parashara's own words there. And Parashara's genealogy already discussed in the in your Sasana is mentioned that Parashara's genealogy. But why did Parashara have this boy Vyasa first produced as his son? He wanted a divine body. That, you know the story, how he produced. Satya Gandhi was there, so then they vote, and how it is produced. That is a divine progeny. And here put a more grain for any sugar in the definition of Buddha. You are not going into that. But the purpose was, he understood Hari, Krishna, and Vishnu is a total distinct power. That thing, in a sense, he imbibed from his own father. Parasha having given that knowledge to him, he must understand, even if he don't know Vishnu Purana, what is the sequence? He is the main sequence is there. Vishnu Purana is the only thing. Sequence is mentioned, creation. The sequence creation. Sequence creation, human creation, human body is a ninth circle. Ninth creation, holiest creation. Ninth creation, the Bible says, God created man in his own image. That is very important. Vishnu Purana mentioned that very, very important. Second aspect, he has found out exactly Jagannatha Dhamma. Many people in Jagannatha Dhamma think they confuse people. Jagannatha is not Vishnu or not Krishna. In the Dakshina Kali, somebody says in the death, this thing, truth of Lord Buddha, somebody says in all sorts of kind, all the stories prevalent in Orissa itself. And very, very few people like Chaitanya Mahaprabhu understood this is Krishna. That Krishna Tua and it's established here. Jagannatha is what? Jagannatha is the Purushottama Masa. This is a holy month. I think on the Sana Purima day, he was born. How was he born? He is a Gada Parvatana. I think with the body is connected. Vasamsi Jirani Yata Vihaya Navani Jirani Yata Vihaya Gada Parivartana after that Gada Parivartana becomes again Purushottama, Nata Janma. Purushottama Janma takes it. It's very clear. Navakara is a Janma to play. There are a lot of problems there. But we don't know about that. What happened that was a political problem. But when Krishna Janma took place, the Purushottama Janma. It's not Krishna Janma. The Purushottama Janma also, there are people here, I think some people, Gaudiya Vaishnava, consider Krishna is the avatari, Jagannath avatar. Then Jagannath, Bhaktas, Purusha, Jagannath is the avatari, Krishna is the avatari. Twiddle and twiddle, how many mistakes? You don't know, you are going to twiddle and twiddle, the mistakes. Who is avatar, who is avatari? Everybody in Sahasranama, Krishna, Narayana, Hari, everything. But ultimately, this is a total purpose of Krishna, Vishnu Purana, to understand Vishnu Bhakta, when Vishnu Bhakta himself, Vishnu Purana says, and he says, Swashloka. स्वपुरुषम अभिविक्ष्य पाशरत्नम वदति यमखिल तस्य कर्णमूले परिहर मधुसूदन प्रपन्नानि प्रभुरम अन्यम प्रभुरम अन्यम न वैष्णवाः. दैट श्लोक एग्जिस्ट इन विष्णु पुराण इन आई थिंक सेक्टेड बाय कलिंग ब्राह्मण. कलिंग ब्राह्मण दे एस्टैब्लिश प्रीवियसली पीपल का कलिंग ये दिस देश इटसेल्फ सपोज अ बेस्ट देश. It's totally incorrect. It is Purushottama. Purushottama Desha, totally Purushottama is there and continue because he came back. I think the Adivasi took that this thing, unborn portion of the Krishna, this thing. All they came back and totally it is established. And there has been this thing between the Raja and him, the Adivasi. And this Jagannatha, this thing was concentrated. I don't know. This, the totality of that must be clear. Whatever the people understand, the totality must be clear. That is an important system in Vishnu Purana. Vishnu Purana clarifies nicely, very clearly. Jagannatha Bhakta is a Vaishnava. Very important. So Jagannatha Bhakta is even our Prabhupada Swami, all the Chaitanya, laid down there. Chaitanya Maharaj is this thing right there itself. He was, I think, Panda's poison put in there, and he also has been drowned in the sea. It's not correct. Probably he is lying there. He is samadhi there. So he sees a temple here, like Ranganatha. Ramanuja is there. Ranganatha temple, Ramanuja is samadhi. So many people samadhi in temples. We are happy. Entaro Mahan Bhavalu Antaranga Vandana. We are happy, we are coming, we are understanding. My main purpose is telling, already time is running out. Like, they are already completed. And today, ultimately, you have established what is the truth. What is, what have come here for? What to understand? Understand God. As that saying our friend said, until understand Hari. Hari is the ultimate. You understand the thing? Narayana, Narayana Paro Jyoti, Atma Narayana Paraha, Narayana Param Brahma, Tattvam Narayana Paraha, Echaki.
Well, we have administrators who are not proficiency over academics, and academicians who don't have proficiency over administrative matters. But here is an academic administrator, Sundar Rajan, IAS officer and of the Bhubaneswar, and he has come all the way from Orissa, and he has done a commendable job in giving us inputs from Vishnu Purana, and marvelously he has pointed out one point that Puranas are not mere myths. This is the exactly the sentence which was spoken by Madhu Pandit Das Ji in the inaugural session as the presidential remarks. Madhu Pandit Das clearly pointed out that Puranas are not mere myths, but there are scientific elements in that. That was re-echoed by Sundar Rajan now, and you see how exactly the great minds, they meet alike. Like water finds its own level, irrespective of wherever you put it. So that shows the quality of the mind and how exactly he has responded in spite of being a very, very busy person. And he nicely brought out Vishnu Purana concerns victory of dharma over adharma, which exactly is the gist of the first stanza of Bhagavad Gita. Kshetre kshetre dharman guru. If you follow Swami Ranganathananda's interpretation of Bhagavad Gita, dharma kshetre guru kshetre samaveta yuyutsava mamaka pandavasteva kimakurvata sanjaya. If you remove all those things in brackets as a common factor, what remains is kshetre kshetre dharman guru. Wherever you are there, you do your dharma. That exactly is what is required in the modern context. He has done his dharma as an administrative officer, and now he is doing dharma as an academician. So here is an administrator and an academician, and also a creative writer in Sanskrit. I appreciate his poems. I don't have time to talk about his poems. Maybe I'll find some other occasion when I can talk about his poetic genius in Sanskrit, based on which I have written some 40 pages so far. So, what I mean to say in this context is, here is a scholar who has done a wonderful job on Vishnu Purana. On behalf of Bharati Vidyavan Bengaluru and ISKCON, may now request Sri Piyush Jain, Honorary Treasurer Bharati Vidyavan, to kindly come to the dais and honor Sri Sundar Rajan. May I now bring to your kind notice that we are shifting the last paper of Dr. Harish to afternoon session, and we will take up that as the first paper in the post-lunch session. And now, Piyush Jain, Honorary Treasurer, Bharati Vidyavan, Bengaluru, is honoring Sri Sundar Rajan, who has come all the way from Bhubaneswar. Let me bring to your notice that the first paper in the afternoon will be by Dr. Harish. He will be speaking to us on Jainism in Puranas. That will be followed by the second paper, Dr. Shilpa Gadhar. She will be highlighting us on personality development according to Puranas. Then Vidwan Narayan Bhatta will speak to us on Vayu Purana. Then Srimati Goda Gopal will highlight us on Puranas and Dravida Veda. And the last paper would be by Dr. Sridhar Hegde. He will speak on Padma Purana yesterday. And then the valedictory program will commence, wherein we are honoring Professor K.T. Pandrangi, Presidential Awardee, and who has been honored by all the Ashtamatas of Udupi, who has celebrated his 97th birthday and who is into the 98th Vasanta. And he will be here to give the valedictory address, wherein Bharati Vidyabhavan Bengaluru, along with ISKCON, will be honoring him on this momentous occasion for his lifetime contribution to Indian culture. And Dr. M. Rama Joyce, who came as an Apat Bandhava to the inaugural session, is also going to be on the dais, and hence we have followed Upakrama Upasamhara Eka Vakyata. Whoever is there on the inaugural day, if they are also there on the valedictory day, we have some kind of logical consonance about the Indian tradition, and there also we have followed tradition. Even in inviting the scholars who are there for the inaugural, will also be there for the valedictory. And now, may I tell you that Krishna Prasadam is being served in Annakota opposite the hall here. And please have your prasadam and please come back here positively at 2 o'clock so that we can commence post-lunch session. Thank you very much. We look forward to you at 2 o'clock.